to Toku Tech. Please subscribe, comment, like, and share. Thank you very much. Okay, so this is going to be my last video about Kodi Media Center. I'm going to go ahead and load a different distro, the OSMC distro of Kodi Media Center. And just to establish that I do have Raspberry Pi creds, I was running XMBC on this one right here, and that's circa 2011. I think that's an original Raspberry Pi. I don't know. You tell me. So each of my 3D printers has this Raspberry Pi 3B running Octopi as a print server. I replaced one of them that looked like this with my Raspberry Pi 4B instance of Octopi. Okay, so we're on the osmc.tv website. Go to the download section, scroll down to the bottom where you get the disk images. Under the disk images there, you're going to find your appropriate Raspberry Pi model. We're looking for the 3B Plus. That's this guy. Let's download that. In my previous video, I unzipped a image file, but with this Belina etcher, you can actually just load the GZ file or the zip file, and it'll actually take care of that for you, just like we see right here. See how it says image file, even though I picked a compressed file. Unlike the LibreELEC implementation, you need a mouse and a keyboard attached to actually get started in OSMC. So I am compressing and cropping here to speed things along. We're firing up OSMC for the first time, and it formats the volume and installs the files, and you just watch. It takes a few minutes, but it was pretty brisk. Then it's going to reboot and come back into the setup screen. And there we go. So here's the basic setup. Select your language. We're going to select a region, America, and a time zone, Phoenix. You can change the name of the device. We're going to set up the Wi-Fi next. Switch on the Wi-Fi, enable the adapter, select your network, put in your password, and off you go. I started to enable Bluetooth, but I didn't recognize the GUIDs, so I went ahead and skipped that step. Skip the rest of these and you can go right out to the end there. Last thing is look and feel. I'm going to go with Classic, just because I'm familiar with the original Kodi. So I'm particularly keen on installing Pluto TV, so we're going to go to Add-ons, Video Add-ons, skipping on down to Pluto. Installing it. Going back out to add-ons to wait to see it land there. Okay, and there's Pluto. Says it's installed. We launch it. Yeah, we're going to go ahead and sign in. Email, password, and we launch channels. Okay, that's it. Pluto TV error. I've tried just about every reasonable attempt to make that work. We're going to have to move on to other things now. So we're going to install the infrared remote and the Bluetooth keyboard. You go all the way down to the bottom, My OSMC, and here you can see the remote icon, and we're going to scroll all the way down to the LIRCD full. I just have a generic entertainment center remote I got from Amazon. And there you have it. Now we're going to turn on Bluetooth. And of course, I've already put my keyboard in discovery mode. So Bluetooth is enabled. We start discovery. Hey, what do you know? There's a Bluetooth keyboard on the list. I'm guessing that's what I'm looking for. Gonna go ahead and pair up with that. Finally, it shows up on the list, so now I can stop the discovery. And we're all set with the infrared remote and the Bluetooth keyboard. Kudos to TechDroid Life 87. Look for the link below. We're going to install add-ons from unknown sources. We're going to add a file source that is mapped to a URL. And then we're going to install add-ons from that URL file source. So first, let's enable unknown sources. You go into System, Add-ons. You might need to be in expert mode like you see here. Unknown sources. Now, there is a disclaimer. You could download something evil, so this is at your own risk. Now we can go to File Manager, and we're going to add a file source. Okay, we're going to browse for network location. See, we're going to toggle through until we get to web server directory, HTTP. Now we're going to type the URL. In this case, it's SRPNU at port 80, and we just click OK. And we can see it's on our list, http://srp.new. Let's escape back out. So now we're going to go into add-ons, and we're going to install add-ons from a zip file. That zip file we'll get from that URL file path. And we're going to get the Krypton zip file. We're going to select all categories to get the whole thing. Yep, see, there you go. You get that big zip. And it's installing, and we're just clicking around. I don't know why. So now we're going to install add-ons from a repository, and we see that Super Repro Krypton repository video add-ons. I'm going to put on Amazon Prime and Netflix. Unfortunately, like Pluto TV and a couple of other add-ons, these didn't work for me. You know, I appreciate it if you leave comments below telling me how to fix Pluto TV, especially. I tend to think the same thing is broken, but I just wanted to show you how to sideload these unknown sources. Again, do it at your own risk, but you're going to find other things like regional language add-ons, etc., and this is how you'll load them. All right, well, let's look at what works. We came up with Popcorn Flix, Shout, NASA TV, IGN, FilmRise, and Crackle. Now, in the NASA TV section, the live videos don't work, the live streams. Like, click on it, and it just cycles through and comes back. I tried that a couple of times. I observed the same thing before. But all the pre-recorded shows do work. I signed into YouTube. That's an experience that I recorded in one of my other videos, so check them out. The only thing I saw on YouTube is I couldn't play PewDiePie's video from yesterday. I don't know why. Maybe there's something around the resolution of the video versus the resolution of the screen. I think I saw some setting where you can say adjust to the video resolution. So I'll have to poke around in settings some more and see if I'm missing something. Okay, so I've tried Kodi Media Center on three different hardware platforms, two different operating systems. So the Raspberry Pi 4, the Raspberry Pi Zero, the Raspberry Pi 3B. And I got similar results between all three. I'm not going to continue to pursue this any further. I'm just going to use this gadget as it works right now, and if I come up with something new, I'll certainly make a video about it. But I hope you enjoyed this and learned a few things. I think adding unknown sources was a good subject to demo, and I hope you had a good time. Thank you very much.
Can you stop distracting me? So where's my house again? I forgot. That's a turtle! Oh my god, hey! Can I ride? Please let me ride the... Don't go!